it's not surprising to me. I think that this process, the way that the mayor and her administration went through this process, I think they had more fumbles than Lamar Jackson in the first half yesterday. And when you add that onto a child being sick, and we know that children are their parents' most valued possession, but then also when you have citizens overwhelmingly show up on Saturday and let the city council know that they do not support this nominee and that they did not support this nominee based on the process and his history, it's not surprising that he would no longer be considered, or he would withdraw.
There's also a reported tweet out there that apparently the mayor advised him to withdraw because apparently his son has to undergo a second brain surgery on Tuesday. Are you hearing anything about that?
I did not, but listen, no one can fault him for doing that with what's going on with his son. I think that people can have questions and concern about someone, but when someone's child is that sick, you have to be sensitive to that and understanding. Like I said, children are their parents' most valued possession, and I think that you just have to hope that the young man has a successful surgery and a full recovery.
Where does this put the process for Baltimore City Police Commissioner?
That means it has to start all over. The mayor has to go through a process. What I believe should happen is a more open and inclusive process that includes hearing from the citizens and includes having put together a group of folks, people that to help with the process. I just hope that they learn from the mistakes of the process that we just went through and put forth a new one as they go and pick someone else.
The mayor had said she had whittled down the process to two or three candidates. Might those other candidates be at the top of the list?
Yeah. I mean, we don't know who they are, so we made the request to find out who the final applicants were and all of that. So the council does not know who those people are, and she could do that. She could choose to go forward with a totally new process. I think that at bare minimum, they have to go through a process that includes public input. They did not do that the first time.
What are you going to advise the mayor to do?
Just listen, to have a more open and inclusive process so that the citizenry of Baltimore, who we all work for and who have the most important voices, are heard, and that we have a transparent process so that we need transformational leadership in the Baltimore Police Department. We need someone with it who's a proven crime fighter and has a history of doing so in a large city capacity, but also someone who can simultaneously, while fighting crime, reform and restructure the BPD.